Hey guys, I got a big old bucket of Buffalo River Chert here that I'm gonna biface and heat treat. I haven't sold very much of this Buffalo River. I actually kept quite a bit of it for myself to have this winter, so I'm gonna go ahead and biface some of it and heat treat it, see how it turns out. Yeah, I'll just go ahead and compensate my partner for his cut of the Buffalo River and keep some of it, because I really like chipping this stuff, especially when it's heat treated. It's really nice. So, I'm going to set that there. Okay, let me get a glove on here. Okay, let's see. Probably use one of these solid billets. I actually prefer to do this standing up, believe it or not. So I can see a bullseye starting right here with the color. But this piece is going to be a little bit large to try to heat treat, so I need to turn this and flatten it off, or I could, yeah, probably flatten it off this way. Pretty slick stuff. Starting to get it turned this way now. It can be hard to do once you start get your plane switched. It's kind of be hard to recover from sometimes. Be a pretty one in that one. Seam in it. Yeah, there's some pretty colors in there. When I heat treat that, oh boy. I guess you guys can see that. Okay, be a good one. Had our annual wild game fry last night. I went up there, they had live music, and man, it was a good time. Got to see a bunch of people I hadn't seen in a while. About every kind of wild game you can imagine. Had a professional chef there this year. Man, everything from just, you know, everything everybody's has killed and cleaned over the last year than on all their crazy trips everybody takes. And so there, you never know what you're going to have there. I brought all kinds of stuff before, showed up with fresh oysters and seafood from the coast and all kind of, you just never know. I go specifically for the drunken snapper. Love the drunken snapper. We catch a lot of snapping turtles around here, and people clean them and eat them. They're one of my favorite wild game meats to eat. They've got several different types of meat in them. As far as texture and color, it all tastes pretty much the same, but they've definitely got lots of different types of meat. So that's a pretty nice piece there. If I can get rid of that little rough stuff on the top here, we'll be good to go. Pretty nice stuff in there. It's getting real soft in there. Nice little biface. There's a bullseye in there. Real dark one. Excuse me. Okay, that'll be fine. Heat treat that one. It's like a piece of fork pain here, maybe. Might be Buffalo River. Yeah. It's all the same stuff. Fort Payne, Buffalo River, Horse Creek. I think it all comes out of the Fort Payne formation. A little rough in there. Heat will help that. Heat treat that one just like that. It's kind of cool the way it changes to brown right there. I don't know if I could heat treat these whole or not. Awful big pieces. I'd be better off to spall them out. Kind of a rough one there. Should slick up with some heat. Bet this is gonna be a good one. Yeah, buddy. Nice, very nice. Put this one in there just like this. That'd make a nice trifacial point. nice one. Looky there, looky there. Bullseye showing up in there. I think there was a seam, a crack going in right there, maybe. I guess they can't all be perfect. Some lighter colored stuff here. Okay. That'll work. This might be a pretty one. Probably heat treat this one just like it is. Pretty piece of chert there. Some stripes in it. Oh, what's this big daddy got going on? It's a bullseye right here. You can see it starting. Almost saw that one, huh? Hoo-wee. pretty stuff. Man, this stuff's gonna be unreal when it's after it's heat treated. Probably work the rest of that little stuff out of there after it's heated. There it went. That's gonna be a pretty one there. Throw him in there and see what happens. Looks like a nice piece here. For those of you wondering about heat treating Fort Payne, I did a batch and I took it up. I did a bunch of different varieties of it and I took it all up to like about 450. And the real nice black stuff, Fort Payne, I had, the real glossy stuff, crazed real bad. And the rest of it, well, there was no change whatsoever. So I'm just gonna chip the rest of my Fort Payne raw, I do believe. people told me that was going to happen, but you know, you got to see for yourself, I reckon. Be a good size to heat treat there. Whoops. It's got some issues in it. It's like a nice piece there. That thing air is flaking pretty good, but I'll go ahead and heat it. Let it gloss up a little bit. Look at this big daddy. That might be a good one to slab there. Maybe I'll set him aside. Be able to heat treat that one. Whoops. Hit that one up too high and a radial crack went in and opened up. Some pretty light colored stuff here. pretty piece of rock here. Piece of black buffalo. This stuff don't need any heat. No, sir. No heat necessary on that one. Nice piece there too. Pretty little druzy pocket in there. Little druzy crystals. All my friends and neighbors around here have been driving by, seeing my garage door open and me in here sitting behind a big pile of rocks. Last night, everybody was saying, man, what you got going on down there? What are you doing with all them rocks? So I'm making stuff. Making stuff. Leave me alone. I'm selling rocks. Having fun. Nah, everybody was like, holy cow, man, I took a piece of that Horse Creek chert up there. But blew their minds. Everybody's getting geared up for deer season. I got an invite to go opening day of shotgun season. A friend of mine bought a bunch of property recently. One of my best friends. He's gonna hook me up, put me in a nice stand. This will be the first opening morning I've hunted in quite a few years. Man. This thing here is just chipping great. Probably tell the heat will probably gloss it up though. You don't say. Talk one end, getting across there. Messed that up. There it is. Knew there was one in there. Beautiful. Might just heat treat this thing the way it is. Dang on it. Pretty rough in there anyway. Be all right. Yeah. That'll work. This black buffalo here, it doesn't need heat. Not at all. Pretty stuff. Love me some Black Buffalo River. Set him over here when I got a little more time to mess with it. kind of butchered that one. All right, let's do one more. Man, that's the best one yet there. It's nice and slick. Looks like it's been heat treated already. Whoops. Too good. Alrighty, guys. What's up, Bear Noodle? I guess that'll be it. I just thought I'd turn the camera on while I did a little bifacing. So, maybe y'all learned something, enjoyed it at least. What's in there? You missed all the action. I'm done napping now. You missed it. All right, guys. I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching, everybody. And thanks to everybody who's been subscribing. I'm like less than 10 people away from hitting 1,000 subscribers. So I really appreciate everybody and all the comments and support and kind words and stuff. It's just overwhelming. So I really, really appreciate everything. And, if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe and hit that like button. Thumbs up. See you on the next one, guys. Peace.